Well, hello there. Can you guys see me? Can you hear me? Is audio okay? I've been setting up everything to go live. We have a lot to do this evening. When it comes to the YouTube stream, I'm gonna update you on the eel. It's not good. And then we're gonna do a feeding of everybody. Ooh. Wait for that. We're gonna feed the rays, we're gonna feed the waru, we're gonna feed the 2000, we will feed the piranha. Puffers already ate today, so I'm not going to bother trying to overfeed them. I think first and foremost, we should take a look at the eel and see what's going on there. Is he alive? Yeah. But is he doing okay? I don't know enough. Is he breathing? Is he moving? Is it still alive? Yeah. Has he ate? No. We're going to try to feed him again today. The last time I tried to feed him was 3 days ago. I said, and you guys watched that part in the last video. I said, screw it. We're gonna let him kind of starve for a few days and see what happens. He is fine. He is doing okay. But we have to also remember that he was just shipped 40 hours, probably closer to 60 hours if I really want to get down to it. Stick a finger in the tank. I will if this video gets 250 likes within the next few seconds. We're at 50. 570 watching. 250 is easy. I'll stick my finger in. Oh, and I'll take my sneakers off, so I won't be grounded. Well, I'm too old to get grounded, but like, you know what I'm trying to say.
He's not too old to get grounded.
You're not the boss of me. Oh, and Tamara's here. Pose for a thumbnail. Come on. well, oh shoot, they're doing it. 206, oh man. We're gonna try to feed him today. It was not the intentions to go live and feed him. The intentions were starve him. You're not hungry, you don't want to eat. Let's make sure you have clean, well-oxygenated water, a great environment, and then I'm going to not feed you for a few days. The electric eel typically eats live fish in the wild. I'm not doing that. And if I have to do it, I won't be doing it on camera. There's plenty of videos out there that glorify it. I don't want to do that. 15 years I've stayed. And I've had morals and integrity, and boy, is it hard, because a lot of things are really cool, but, oh shoot, they did the 250. All right, let's start with your bullying. Take off the forces. Just some socks, some cute little socks. You ready? And put my hand in. Hopefully it's not that bad. Whew. He's about, would you agree that's about a foot away? Feet, concrete floor. Why isn't it shocking me? Because it's not an electric eel. No, it's definitely an electric eel. No, it's, what could that be? I don't know what that could be. The reason it's not shocking me is because it's not producing enough. You have to touch it. I didn't know that. I didn't know as much as I thought I knew. And I know that you guys don't know as much as you thought you knew. And what my goal and my plan here is to educate properly. Just like piranhas, I know that some people were mad at me for making them look more docile than they really are. And to be fair, President Roosevelt definitely kind of gave them that ferocious man-eating reputation. And I can even go through that story. It's absolutely fascinating. But the reason why I'm not getting shocked, well, he's not even moving around, right? Let's agitate him. Let's move him around. Can you see him moving around? So he should be upset right now. No. No. He's not gonna be able to shock me. Not grounded or not, you have to touch him to get that 600, 800 volts of electricity coursing through your body. Is it enough to hurt you? Is it enough to like, well, I guess if it continues to shock you, yes, if you're continuously holding it, but I'm not gonna touch it. Touch it with a fork. No, you 1,000 likes and there's not 1,000 people here, I'll touch it with a fork. No, I'm not doing that. Because I'll definitely, well, what's the fork? Can I use a plastic fork? We have to set the rules here. Let's go over how and why the electric eel is electric in the first place. Absolutely fascinating to think about and talk about. And one of the things that I love, and I'm gonna break it down in a future video, but imagine, I'll use this to light my candles. So what? I live a candle-lit life. Imagine this as a AA battery. You have a positive and a negative. Everybody knows that. You gotta put the plus sign in where it's supposed to go and the negative sign where it's supposed to go. The electric eel has a ton of these cells. The bigger the eel, the more cells it has. The bigger the eel, the bigger the or the bigger the battery, the bigger the charge. Part of it is a positive and part of it is a negative. And in between, I'm going to put this into layman's terms. It's a bit of a mucus that's separating them. However, when the eel sets off this chemical reaction in its brain to like, okay, release the shock, for a moment, the mucus is more conductive and the positive and negative connect, producing that electricity. Fascinating and incredibly interesting. However, I'm not gonna bust it down. one of my mixtapes is in the description below, but I'm going to break it down to a point where I can explain it for absolutely anybody to understand so that the next time you see an electric eel, the next time it comes up in conversation, you can explain it in a way that anybody can possibly understand it. What I'd like to do next is, I don't know if you guys were watching the live in the last, in the premiere. I love doing those premieres, by the way, because I love sitting here and seeing your reaction and I get to watch the video again for the first time. But if you were reading the comments, somebody said, add almond leaves or catalpa leaves. And I said, you guys remember this? These from the unboxing? I've done nothing with them. So they would also be called Indian almond leaves. Aquascape Room Canada sent them to me, extra large. I'm a normal sized human. Although when people meet me, they always say, oh, I thought you would have been taller. I don't want to hear that anymore. And that's why I'm wearing Air Force Ones today. They give me an inch. They had an extra inch. Did you just hear what she said? How do I make sure you guys can't hear what she says? Everybody loves an extra inch. Anyways, and they're actually quite nice. Let me show you something though. What happens to organic materials when you add them to the aquarium? They're going to waste away. Idioma almond leaves, they will rot, but they do add a tremendous amount of tannins. Mind you, this is the Walru tank and that Val used to go all the way to the top. It does no longer because the Walru obviously is a plant-eating fish. And I'm gonna be abundantly honest, I don't care that they're a plant-eating fish. The plants are in there, well, to make it look absolutely gorgeous, but at the same time, I just want them to be fat and healthy and do really well, long-term. You know, do I care that we have the Val? Yeah, I think it would be absolutely phenomenal to have that long-term, but do I want the Panda Walru more than I want the Val? Yeah. And will this tank still look cool with those three, with the wood and the rocks? Yeah, I think so. It's not that big of a deal. We're gonna feed these guys and I'm gonna get them out. I promise you there are fish in there. Oh, we'll even feed this tank. Who else will we feed? Anyways, first and foremost, and Tamara, you're gonna have to take this for a second. Deal? What's that?
Can I stroke your electric eel?
I dare you to stroke the electric eel. Don't look at me like that. I dare you to touch him. You can go get my wallet, and I'll give you $500 cash if you touch it.
I didn't mean him.
Disgusting.
Hey, Mom.
Yeah, yeah. That's somebody's daughter. Jeez. Anyways, I'm going to go back to making this. We're on YouTube, by the way.
We're not on Twitch. On Twitch, you can talk like that. On YouTube, you cannot.
Okay.
That escalated quickly, Dark said.
I'm sorry.
Mixed signals here.
I'm sorry.
I follow you. I need subtitles for your video, no English. Demonetize. She can be my daughter. Okay. Can you grab this?
My mom really said hey, Tamara.
Is she there?
She's there. Hi, Mom.
Your mom is here?
My mom's here.
Do you see how she acts? Oh, chat. Okay, this is an inappropriate question. I'll give you the question and then I'll give you the answer. Who do you think's hotter, Tamara or her mom? I'll give you like 15 seconds to answer that question. And I gotta add these while you guys guess.
Shout out to my mom. Lily.
The answer is, Tamara's mom is way hotter than Tamara. I picked the wrong one, gentlemen.
Wow, wow, wow.
Come film down here.
Tamara's mom has got it going on. Sorry, I get distracted easy.
Yeah.
So look at those leaves.
They're going to float for a short while. I think that we probably could have and should have fed first, but another option is to boil these so they sink immediately. What I find happens though is you also lose a tremendous amount of the tannins that you kind of want, and all the botanicals and all that extra, greatness that these guys add to it. I'm trying to act like I'm an Indian almond leaf expert. I have no clue what's in them. I do know that it can potentially soften the water. You need an absolute tremendous amount to do that. I do know that they do release tannins. Mind you, come in close. I'm putting my hands in every single time. I am not, I'm fine. Everything's okay. All right, back up.
I've boiled so many leaves.
Yeah, you helped me. I've done it originally, but I found it incredibly boring. So the idea behind this tank here is, it's darkening the tank. We'll let them sink and see what happens. The eel is becoming a little bit more active, so his sac organ is probably clicking. We can't hear it right yet, but we will shortly. I'm going to be putting in a speaker that will be able to listen to him at all times. I fear that it will be annoying because when something does not shut up, it doesn't matter how beautiful it is, it becomes annoying. And I think maybe I could take it out eventually, but I think it would be kind of cool to hear it. Get a closer look at him. So it is a scaleless fish. And if for a moment, now if this was on any other fish, see the dents in its head? If this was in any other fish's head, you would assume that it has hole in the head disease. These are more sensory organs within the electric eel. Right now I'm rooting for the eel. The other thing I wanna do, not only do I wanna have the speaker, but I also want to put on a Tesla coil. So you guys know the Tesla coils, they put off the sparks. I gotta figure out a way to wire it to the tank so that when he's eating and that when they eat, they put off the hunter's organ and the main electrical organ. And that's enough to light up that. So wouldn't that be cool where we have a Tesla coil? A basic light, like something like this. I think that's kind of cool. It's a very fun, interesting idea, but I think we could do something cooler. We're gonna try to feed them. Shoot. Should I try to hand feed him, make sure it goes near his face? Or should I just drop it in the tank and hope he tastes it? It is 180 gallons of water, so it might get relatively diluted in there. He will not eat that, somebody said. So these are raw smelts. I feel like you need it. I'm going to cut it down a bit though. Use some rubber tweezers. I don't have any. Let me see here.
You can use your regular ones.
What?
You could use your regular ones.
They're stainless steel.
I know. It was a joke.
Let's think on our feet. This is plastic, not a great conductor of electricity. I don't think. This is a zip tie, not a great conductor of electricity. I don't think so. Let's tie. Oh, just put it in through there. This is an algae scraper without the scraper part. And we'll take it and we'll loosely put it in here. Just enough to hold on to it. Yeah, he can tug that out. Can you grab me the scissors over on the wall, please? Yeah, I don't want to cut it off. With enough voltage, that thing can be a conductor, yeah. I think it's, I don't know what this is made out of. You know what? We're going to find out. Oh, how many likes you guys got? I'm doing this for you. 390, 1,000 people watching. Wow. So you hate me. Translation, you guys hate me. I'll do this. I'm over here e-begging for likes. That's what my life has come to. I'll do it for 500. Get it to 500, I'll do it. Drink my root beer. Plastic tongs from the kitchen. I don't think I have plastic tongs. 465. Smells gross. I'm having flashbacks.
Not for me.
No, flashbacks. You are current. They did the 500. Chopsticks might work, yeah. I don't have chopsticks. Bet they'll hand feed. Oh, we'll hand feed them next. I've never been able to hand feed them. I never did. All right. He's also needs a name. Eat. Eat. Eat your veggies.
He's a picky boy.
I wish somebody would, like, feed me by like rubbing it across my lips like this and like, don't you want to eat this?
I do.
And then I'm just laying around like that and be like, no, I don't like it. No, I don't want it. No, I'll chase him around till he, oh, my hands are in the water. That's not going to be good. He's found a loophole in the system. In order for me to get this to him, I have to dip my fingers in. Well, kind of. Maybe if I could just move him out of the way. Without my fingers touching, I don't think it's going to be possible. This is the most ridiculous live video I've ever done. Okay, move back, bro. Please, just eat. Well, it's only been 3 days. We got him on Wednesday morning. I don't know how many days they didn't feed him for. The shipper said they were feeding him krill, but yeah, he's just getting upset. He's like, man, I'm not hungry. I'm not getting shocked, though.
Whiny baby.
He's not a whiny baby. He's a big man. He's just not going to eat it. That's fine. Maybe 2-3 more days. And that's what I'll do. I offer the food. He doesn't eat it. I'll take it out. And that's that. Now, we're going to name him live. I'm going to ask you guys what you think he should be named. I will give you 10 seconds to come up with a name. I will see, oh, Raiden's good. Flash, Bolt, Sparky, Edison, Dangerous, Thor. Okay. Ooh, I thought I knew what I wanted. Zeus. Okay. I don't know how to start. Oh, I can. You guys want to do a poll?
Do a poll.
Okay, we're going to do a poll.
Oh my God, they're going so fast.
Tesla. Meat tube. Okay, let's start a poll. I'm only going to let the poll stay up for 3 minutes. Because we got a night ahead of us, and I got to go live over on Twitch. Because I got to start building. If you guys don't know, on Twitch, I'm going to... The rack's done. I haven't even put that video out yet. I'm going to install the backgrounds and lighting. And talk about which what's going in what tank. So if you don't have anything planned for tonight and you need to burn 3 or 4 hours, join me over on Twitch. It's in the pinned comment. And that just links to my Twitch channel. You can join for free.
If you don't have Twitch, sign up.
Okay. Add an option. Eel name. I'll do three that I liked. Mind you, it's my damn fish. I gotta like the name. What was another good one? Okay, yeah, that's a good one. Okay, there's three options. If I didn't say your name, or if I didn't say your recommendation, it's not because I don't like you, it's because I hate you. No.
So harsh.
I just think these three are probably the best. One of them I just saw, and I was like, yeah, that could work. Okay, here comes the poll. You guys will have 3 to 3 minutes. And go. Zero votes so far. Let's see how this goes. Oh, there's a battle now. 83 votes in. Watson. Thor is winning. Watson is second. Elon is third. It looks like it's going to be close. And to be honest, I don't care which one it is. They're all great. I don't think there's enough for 3 minutes of voting. There's only 1,100 here, and there's already 400 votes.
Hurry up and vote.
At 500 votes, I'll shut it down. So get them in. 500 votes, I shut it down. And sorry for this. I don't want you to see the bald spot on my head. No, I don't have a bald spot on my head. I have a receding hairline.
Him got all the hair.
My hair is scared. Even my hair is scared of my face. Okay, 471 votes, 476. I'm definitely ending it at 500. It's only been 1 minute, 488, 494. Come on, 500, end. What was it? I didn't even look.
It's
Thor. That's pretty cool. Yeah, I wanted Thor anyway. So that worked out. I was cool with Watson though, because that's a pretty cool, interesting name. Elon, you know, that's Elon's, you know, Elon Musk with Tesla, the
no,
electric.
Elon.
Oh
shit! It took
me
a while. It took you longer.
I missed out on it. That would have been great. Elon.
Yeah.
What? I thought they were saying Elon.
Yeah, I did too. And then I was like, no, they mean Elon.
Okay. There's been a disqualification. I thought you guys were spelling it wrong. I was like, that's not how you spell Elon. Okay. W's in the chat if you want me to redo the poll with the proper spelling.
I wonder how many
you
other
have to flood the chat and drown out everybody else. If you want a new poll, we'll put Thor against Elon. Okay, yeah. So I seen somebody say no right away and then just went brrr. Okay.
Okay.
Last time. It's gonna be against the two. Start a poll.
These guys gotta go.
Just put them over there. I gotta feed the rays here in a minute. Okay, so Elon. How do you spell eel?
E E.
How do you guys want it spelled? E E L O N. Okay. And Thor. Damn, Haley's gonna be pissed. All right.
Oh, shout out to Squeeze a Small Engine, gifted 5 King of DIY memberships. That might have... So when you gift a membership, it goes to people that are actively watching the chat or watching the video. And the downside to that is when you become a member and you don't really have time to join this channel, there's a lot to catch up on. Okay. Here it comes. When do we shut it down? There's 1,100 watching. I think we could shut it down at... Well, we just did 500. No, we'll do it again. We got to keep the parameters relatively close and relatively the same. And here it comes. Elon. At least that's more meme-y. Thor is a cool name, I guess, but I think there's more memes and more things that we could talk about.
It took me quite a while, but I'm glad I got it before you.
Like, maybe Elon will buy OnlyFans, like the members of my membership of my channel.
Elon.
Yeah, and allow... Elon. Although we got to work on pronunciation, too. Elon's on it. We've got 440 votes. 70 versus 30. Oh, damn.
Okay, clearly everyone didn't get Elon either, because... It would have gotten more fun.
Elon Armstrong. Elon is good. Elon. Elon, what could be his last name? Not Musk. Maybe. Yeah, screw it. He can have Elon Musk. Elon. I just don't want to get, like, sued by the richest man in the world.
Yeah, that would suck.
A lawsuit from him would just... he'd even make sure that he got my fish.
What's a good last name for Elon?
Elon. Do you guys want a Elon Muck? Elon it is. You guys were here. You guys voted. Okay, we have pretty much... I'll let you vote on the last name. Damn it. At least these guys are like got funny ones. Okay, last thing, and then we gotta feed the fish. Eel last name? Question mark? What did they call it? Elon
Muck.
Elon Muck. Because he's in mud. And what was the other one they wanted? What was the other one? Oh, Sparks.
Sure.
Chalk. Okay. 500 in 3, 2, 1. Go. I don't know why I'm doing a countdown because they literally were only doing 500. I hope they do Muck. Elon Muck. I love it. Elon Sparks is still pretty good too. But Elon Muck is like that is like Elon, right along with Elon Musk. Elon. No, what's his name? I can't even.
Elon Musk.
How do you say his normal name?
Elon Musk.
Elon. And how do we say his name? Elon?
Elon.
Elon Muck. This is Elon.
Elon.
Tweet that he had Elon. I don't have Twitter. I can't. I don't want to wake up to that kind of drama. I've never had Twitter. I registered for Twitter once because someone was pretending to be me and asking for money and donations and all this stuff. So I registered and I was like, no, that ain't me. And then I deleted my account or like deactivated it. We're at 416. Come on, guys. Get it to 500 so we can start feeding the fish. We got some hungry fish. 424. It's not moving fast enough. I think that at 66, Sparks can't come back after this. Even if it all went to Sparks. It just can't come back. It would still be Muck. Elon Muck. Okay. Now I gotta stick to it. They want 500, so they'll get 500. Might as well look at him, though.
What the people want.
Elon Muck. And Luke Mullen. Get out, don't touch my phone. You want one of these knuckly sandwiches? Didn't think so. And then he's got his... What was that?
Nothing.
Ooh, I like Volt. Yeah, there's a few great names. All right, did it get to 500 yet? We're gonna end it. You guys legitimately picked this. 472. You guys gave up on it. 474, 475. Well, I'm not going to wait here all night for this. Come on, guys. Elon Bolt. Should have called him Usain Bolt. 20 more, or 20 more. Look, I'm watching myself. I'm such a narcissist. That's what I do when nobody's around. I just watch my videos. No. Sometimes I like...
I wear that shirt with me on it, so...
Yeah. So the fish we're going to feed as we wait for you guys to finish up on the pole. We will be feeding the rays. I stole one of their lights. They didn't need a lot of lights. Plus, I'm getting like algae throughout the tank, and I'm tired of scrubbing it, so... next time I want to clean it, I'll scrub it and then lower the lighting. Well, it's got half the light, so we're not going to really run into those issues. I can see them perfectly. I like it to be a little bit more dimmer anyways.
Elon Musk charges his own car.
I think you guys are done the 500. Yeah, 511. Okay, Elon Musk. Wow, that's pretty good. We're also going to feed this tank. If you look closely and at an angle, you can kind of see... there's a bit of, you know, bacteria and algae built up on the viewing panel. The tank is not foggy. It shares the water with them, guys. But you come over here, and it's, you know, crystal clear. You can see everybody just perfectly. Oh, can I zoom with this? I cannot. That's fun. We'll feed this tank and feed the rest, too. Let's start with these guys here. This is the Frontosa Aquarium. Of course, they're all darting away now that I'm over here. They hate me. And we should have some shell dwellers out and about. I wonder if we have any babies now that they're in here. I don't know if you guys see any. I see a few shell dwellers out. Don't see any there. You know what? I might have to feed... Oh, the walrus were just out. There's one. He's missing his homie. They all come out at the same time. And it's just so random. Oh, don't let me chase you over this way. Go back over there. Over there. Nope. There, yeah. Go with your homies. There you go. They all like to hide back there. Okay. Can you hold the camera while I do this stuff, please? I gotta do the feeding.
Make sure it's facing me. Just kidding.
I'm going to try hand feeding the rays for the first time. We're going to feed them these massive pieces of smelt and see how that goes. I'm going to need that chair.
Oh. My lazy butt trying to sit down every chance I get.
All right. Do you want one, Luke? You always think you're going to have one.
Luke wants a smelt until he smells it.
Take it.
Till he smelts it.
He doesn't like it.
Gross. I don't like it either.
You think these guys would shock me? Now I think everything is...
They're gonna... No. They're gonna sting you. Just kidding.
Hey guys, who wants it?
Aww.
Come get it.
Have a snack.
You see his mouth?
Yep.
Hey,
got
it. Ripped it right out of my hand. All right,
who was that? That was...
Come here, Mama.
The smaller girl.
Come here, Mama.
Giving Big Mama one now.
Yeah, she's a big girl.
Oh, yeah, oh, she loves it. Now the boy needs one.
Where is it?
Right there.
Come here, Bubba. Come here, son. Come see your daddy. Right here.
Luke thinks you're talking to him.
Hey, buddy.
What up,
this?
For me?
I'm just going to throw it to him. I don't have Go-Go Gadget arms. Hope he gets it.
Big Come Mama's on. Like, nah.
Come on. Oh, yeah.
Oh, good boy.
God.
Good boy, Luke.
I'll trick him. Hey, Luke, ready? Sit. No, I don't, because he will grab it. He's just a good boy, so he will grab it.
Yeah, well, you don't care when you do it to me. Joey likes to slap these across my lips out of nowhere, and it's awful. I hate it.
Don't tell everybody how gross I am. There's not much left, but we do have a ton of other food over there, so I've got to feed everyone. Yeah, the Arowana got the big one. Arowana got that gluck.
Oh, look at the catfish. He's gonna get something.
Where is he?
He's right there in the back. Right there.
They're all looking, but
silly him. It's way in the back.
Here.
Oh, over there. It's over there.
Go get
right
it.
Right beside there. Yep. Oh. He knows.
Luke's like, what?
Luke,
what?
You don't know.
What are we getting, Daddy?
All right, take this again. I'm just gonna drop a bunch of food in there and I'll eat.
Ready?
Yep.
And then I'm gonna feed the rays some more.
The ways you have to sit when you're filming are just fucking weird.
Watch your
mouth,
please.
Messed up weird.
Don't do that again. YouTube doesn't tolerate that at all. Jeez.
Do-do-do-do.
Should all be now.
Yeah, thumbnail fail. F's in the chat for Tamara.
Yeah. It's not good, guys.
So disappointed in you. I added in a pile of rocks. The fish seem to be a little happier. Oh, did that Pleco just go after that Severum? Oh, he's got something. What do you got? The Bicher's eating. Everybody's getting something.
They're all coming through. For everyone.
Let's go ahead and get the ray some food, something to eat. And then we have to do the piranha. Yeah, I gotta put Tamara in timeout. Now, we'll do the piranha next. I have to close the outside door though. So all the food is pre-mixed. Well, we make it and then we put it in a bag like this, freeze it. When I need to feed them, I just take it out. It seems to be the right amount. If I gotta feed everybody, I'll get two bags, but if I just need to feed one tank, then a lot of the times this will do. And I can give others like a quick little snack. I'm likely just going to feed live food or this frozen food. How do I open this? Just a sec. I'm just gonna have to sit here for a minute while I open this. I don't know why it won't open. Because I closed it. Well, or did I just close it again? I closed it again? No. Okay. Salt water planted. Look how beautiful this is. Isn't that absolutely stunning? The rays are hungry though. Let's give them a little juice. A little juice. Just get them riled up. You guys ready? Time to eat, boys.
Ooh.
Look at the plants growing everywhere. Please be more respectful of my scape. 700 gallon, 8 feet long, 5 feet front to back. Stands about 2.5 feet tall. Gallons, 30 red belly piranha. So they'll come picking at it, keep eating it. There's enough food for everybody, but what they'll do is one will grab it and then run off, and then another one will grab a piece and they'll run off, like they're all fighting for it. See, watch. Grabbed a piece. Oh, no, he got it. Maybe they're starting to get full. This is the only tank that I watch overfeeding because clearly I don't really clean it, but some of the moss here fell off. It's all growing back, clearly. But look at it all over here now. Everywhere. It's infected the tank. I'll never get it all out. And all of these plants, remember when this was just sand? I gotta get rid of that. These plants here are the same as that big tall one. It's the same as those ones. It's sporadically planted, but this one's even flowering up there. Just a beautiful aquarium. And then there's a massive pile of moss over here on the intake of a filter. Just this plant for some, and it's one light. Like I don't know what I'm doing that is causing an explosion of growth in the plants. No clue. I keep hitting the phone. Okay. So that was fun. So I gotta go live for quite some time and do a quick build out. I'm doing it on Twitch. If you're not following me on Twitch, it's free to do so. I'm going to leave a link to it right now in the chat. I'll even pin it. And make sure you follow me over there. I'm definitely going live within the next for the next 5 or 10 minutes. Enough time for you to go grab a drink, grab something to eat, bag of chips, whatever you want to do. If you don't have anything else going on for the evening and you want to spend it with us, make sure you follow on Twitch. Again, it's free to follow. Just make sure you're turning notifications on. And if you're not registered for Twitch or whatever, I'll give you 5-10 minutes. It's all free. But just in case you're not, just keep refreshing the page. I'm coming. It's just going to take me a while. That's why all the microphones are set up. The lights are going. Well, that one's not going, but... you'll have 3 different camera angles, one from here, another from there, and another one from there as we finish building out this rack. So that's it, guys. I will see you there shortly.